Quick reminder for our church family, Tuesday Bible study, 4 p.m. Pacific. See ya.
I have 3 points. Well, first I'll say that it's kind of, this message was super timely because last night I had a dream that I was getting ready for my job, you know, woke up, getting ready to go to work. And I looked outside and there was a huge, like, RV bus, and I kind of want one of those, and it was pink, and it was nice, and I was like, oh my gosh, is that mine? And my roommate comes out of nowhere and says, no, that's mine.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. I was like, you got one of those? He's like, yeah, for when I like take trips and stuff. And I'm like, yeah, but you like don't do that very often. He's like, yeah, well, I bought it. And I was just like, well, how are you going to pay for it? You know, pay it off. And he's like, yeah, I'll make payments. But I'm renting a room from him. So my mind was like, my money is going to go towards your RV, not mine.
Yeah.
And I was like, well, you think like maybe you would rent that out? And he was like, no. And I got so mad, I started crying. I was really angry. And luckily, my alarm went off like right when that happened because I was super upset. Like probably was crying. And I was like, God, why? What? How does he have what I want in life? So I woke up and I was like, that was really weird, but I didn't know what I had that dream for. I even was like, God, what the heck does that mean?
Uh-huh, no confirmation.
So, there we go.
Wow.
And also, you know, I felt when I woke up, like, even though I was angry, I immediately knew that I was being entitled.
Yeah.
Like, why should I be angry that he has something that I don't have, even though I want it? It's his. No, it's not guaranteed in life that I'm going to get what I want. And right. I was like, this sucks, man.
Yeah.
And, so that message was, for me. And then, recently, over the last month, I've been doing pretty good about this year, you know, I moved in here, in this apartment, and actually left the boxes unpacked because I was trying to believe by faith that I wasn't going to be in this place for very long. I was like, I don't want to be here. I don't like this place. I'm pretty sure it'll just be a transition. It's been a year.
Yep.
So I've just been kind of increasingly getting angry about it, actually, over the past month. Angry, just upset. I'm like, this isn't fair. I hate it. I'm starting to get, like, really annoyed with them, like, more and more being like, I don't like these people. I don't want anything to do with this place. I want to get out of here. So, once again, you know, God's basically telling me my timing, you might not end up getting out of there. The end of things. I'm like, okay. And then the story you were telling me about, you were talking about people you know, loving their family members enough to let them go. It reminded me of, there's a book called The Great Divorce by C.S. Lewis in it. In the book, people from hell get to visit heaven, and they hate it. Because everybody in heaven isn't bitter, they're not angry, they're at peace. And so these people from hell come, and they run into old family members and things like that, and they're like, how can you just smell my face? You know, you did this to me 30 years ago. And they're like, I forgive you for it. You know, I'm sorry that I made you upset. And they're like, no, we can't just be friends. You know, they're really angry, bitter people.
Yeah.
And one of the people in the book is the smothering mother. So she loved her son so much. She didn't realize that she actually, her son, she's like, where's my son? You know, when she goes to heaven, she's looking for her son. She's like, hey, like, I get to see my son again. She runs into her brother-in-law. She's like, where's my son? And they're like, you can't see your son. And she's like, why? It's my son, you know? And then he tried to tell her, you know, when the son got sick and died, you know, secretly, he was ready to go. He was like, I can't wait to get out of here. You know, she was like, no, you know, you can't leave. She made everybody in the house very bitter. when the son died, because like they all wanted to move and get rid of the stuff in the house because it was just, you know, painful memories. And she said, nope. I mean, it was like the bedroom was a shrine to him,
right,
you know,
right.
And that's all she ever talked about. And, you know, she'd meet people and be like, yeah, let me tell you about my son, you know, and just totally ignore her kids that were still alive. Her husband left her over it. She did not realize that her love was actually controlling. It was manipulative. And it was overbearing. She had no idea. And the guy in heaven was trying to tell her that, but she just ended up getting really angry and saying she wanted to go back. Like,
wow.
She's like, if I can't see my son, then I don't even want to be in heaven.
Wow. You know?
It was pretty crazy. Yeah. Really crazy. It's a really awesome book, actually. But yeah, I just wanted to say that reminded me of that. But that was a good message, Miss Pat. I guess I need to put my seatbelt on and get comfortable.
God bless you, girl.
I can't
take any more of it. You reminded me of a dream, Andrea, that I had the other day. In this dream, it was in the weirdest form, like a balloon-like creature. That it was the weirdest looking thing. I don't even know what it was or what you can call it. Because I wasn't even thinking about that at all that night, like before I went to sleep. I was talking with Sabrina. And then I just wind up going to sleep a little bit after that. But in the dream, basically, I had no fear. Like, you know, which is not me in the real world, because I do. But in all my dreams, whenever I fight a demon, I'm never afraid at all. Even if I can see, even if I see it, it's just the fear is just not there. Mm-hmm. Nothing. And my main thing is fighting it with the word, like, you know, in Jesus' name.
Right.
So in this dream, it's like I got a hold of it, and I grabbed it, and I could tell it was trying to resist. Mm-hmm. It was afraid of me. Mm-hmm. It was trying to get the heck away from me. Mm-hmm. It was like trying its best to run, and it was like a creature. Like if you ever watch a sci-fi movie, and those little aliens, how they move all weird, and they
yes.
that's the best way I can describe what it even looked like or what it was. And I was holding it, and I know I was like, in the name of Jesus, I was rebuking, I was casting, and the weirdest thing happened is where I started hearing the noise of you know how you have someone is in a hospital and they're about to die, and you hear that beep, beep, beep.
Yes. Oh,
I started hearing that. Yeah, I started hearing that noise. It was as I was squeezing it, because it was trying to resist. It was like filling itself with air. Like, that's why I said it was like a balloon-like mm-hmm. thing or air. It can fill itself up and breathe or whatever, and I was holding it, and I kept doing that, and I was in the name of Jesus, and then it was like beep, deflate. It deflated, and then it came back, then it started breathing again. I said, in the name of Jesus, I just was like using the word of God, and I was just saying a lot of stuff, I can't remember all I said, and then it said beep, beep. And then it didn't move no more. It was dead. And I was like, oh, wait a minute. Let me make sure this thing is gone. And I kept saying, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And it was just, it wouldn't move no more. It was dead. The way it looked like it died, like you said, like that.
Yes.
And it was it. It was, and I woke up.
Okay. You know what came to my mind when you said that? That
what?
Was probably a moment of intercession for someone else that was being attacked.
Oh.
Whether they were on their deathbed or whether they were in a precarious situation, you did battle with something that was trying to suck the life out of something else. That's out of someone else. That's the feeling I got. Was that
and
you?
I left a,
yeah, go on.
And I left a part out.
Yeah.
When it slipped from out of my hands, it went under the bed, and I said, oh, no. And I went on the bed and looked for it. And when it saw me, it jumped out of bed. And that's when I caught it.
Yes.
And that's when I started doing it that last time.
Right.
So it was trying to get away from me.
Exactly.
Whatever that thing was.
Exactly. And sometimes God will force a demon to manifest himself to us so we can do battle, because the person they're attacking can't do battle on their own.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Very good. Thank you.